Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today it's going to be my second vlog and I'm so happy that you guys enjoyed my first vlog. Yes, the view numbers are not that great, but I have got lot of comments and lot of messages saying that you guys enjoyed the vlog and you want to see more, like a house tour and all other stuff. So definitely I'm going to make more vlogs for you guys. And do support me, like my videos, and also comment below your feedback, just what you liked in the vlog and what you didn't like it. So I will definitely consider all your suggestions. And today is June 2nd and time is around 5:40. I just logged off from the work and I'm going to make tea, and you can see my house everywhere. It's a big mess, so I have to clean up. I will do only a quick cleanup every day. I am not going to deep clean. Deep cleaning is for some other day, not today. On a weekday I like to do quick cleanup and relax. So let's begin the video. So first I want to show these baskets to you guys. I have been wanting to buy like woven baskets for a very long time now, and I got my hands on some of these baskets and they look so pretty, and I'm using these baskets to put all my produce. So somebody asked in my previous video that what do I do with green tomatoes. I just make sometimes chutney, green tomato chutney, but most of the times I just leave them like this on my island, and after a couple of days they started to ripen. As you can see, it started to get orangish yellow and soon it will be red, just like these. So once they turn this color, I just use them in regular cooking. And let me show you the other baskets I got. So I got these. So I'm going to use these to organize, to put things in, and it gives me like really good feeling, like all the memories of growing up in India. So these three are of the same design, and this is a big one with two small ones, and this one are two big baskets. I'm probably going to store my potatoes in this basket. Let me know in the comments below if you want to see how I store my tomatoes, onions and potatoes for a long time. So these are the baskets I got. Let me know in the comments below if you liked my baskets. So yesterday I went to Costco in the evening. So it's been almost 2.5 months that I went to Costco. We just wanted to get some soil for our plants, but they ran out of soil, so they don't have any soil now. But we did end up buying a lot of stuff for the house. So one thing I really liked is these notebooks. So I think 3-pack of notebooks is around $9. So the design is really cute, and one I already started using for my work. So they have divisions too, like you can, so these are basically 3 subject notebooks. So each book is divided into 3 parts. So I like to plan all my YouTube content and all my blog content, how I outline and everything. So this and the book is of really good quality. So if you are looking for notebooks, definitely check them out. So I'm in my living room. I just wanted to show you a quick overview. So I do have some plastic covers on the floor, which I'm supposed to recycle, and some mess over on that sofa. Tidy up this blanket over the sofa. The reason why we keep the blanket is because we always put our legs on the sofa, and this sofa is light colored one, so we don't want any dust to accumulate on the sofa or any stains. So that's why we use this big blanket, so it really helps protect the sofa. And some mess over the table here. It's okay. So this is how the living room looks right now. Not so bad. And that's my kitchen. We have an open kitchen plan. So the most messiest part is always the kitchen, like I told in my previous video. Everything lands up on the countertops. So I'm going to clean that.
Like a bird on a tree, I'm just sitting here.
So how many of you save these pickle jars to reuse them? So I save all of them and I always reuse them. And if I have too many to store, then I'll probably donate them or recycle them. But mostly I will save them and use them.
Together, it's so beautiful, you and me. Meant to be in the great outdoors, forever free.
So I want to quickly show you what are these. So we have styrofoam covers that we usually get when we buy fruits. So we don't throw them away, we save them and we use them in the garden. And later in the video I'll show you how we use these covers in the garden. So let me know in the comments how many of you are a chai person or coffee person. I am both, but I love my chai. At least I'll have one cup a day with cardamom and ginger. So let me know in the comments. And I believe that chai is a stress buster. Like if you are having stress or if you have nothing to do, if it's raining, anytime, chai is the best medicine. And even though if I have a cup of tea right now, let's say after 1 hour somebody mentions chai, I immediately get cravings to drink one more cup of chai. Does that happen to you? Let me know in the comments. So I want to clear my dining table as well as the rest of the island, but my chai is almost done, so I'm going to drink it and then I'm going to continue with the tidying up and then I'll cook something for dinner. So today for dinner I'm thinking to make tomato chutney and I'm going to make it spicy because these tomatoes are almost soft and fully ripened, so this will make a really good chutney. So I will show you the recipe when I make it. So in my previous vlog, so many of you asked where is the strainer from. I honestly don't remember, guys. Maybe it could be from Indian store or Amazon. I doubt it's from Amazon. I think it's from Indian store or it's from my India trip. But if I find a good strainer with nice reviews, then I will link it in the description box below. So here is my chai with some snack and I'm watching Once Upon a Time. It is a fairy tale fictional kind of TV series. I really like it. And today I'm drinking alone because my husband had late lunch, because he was doing some work, so it got a little bit late for him, so he's not going to drink tea with me. So I'm going to watch this alone. Usually I like to drink my tea outside in the backyard, but it's so sunny right now, that's why we closed the blinds too. So this direction is west, so sun sets in this direction and lot of sun in the evening hits us. So I'm going to enjoy my tea. So I cleared the dining table of all the unwanted items and I put the extra baskets here. I have used a couple of them already. And this is the mat that we got for our office chair. This is from Costco. So you can use this both on carpet and hardwood floor. So it is around $30. We still need to open it up and use it, but for now it's here. So this area is done, and have already cleared the living room, and here also I cleared. So these will go into the fridge, and I will use them in the cooking today, and this will stay right here until they become fully ripened. So these will stay right here so that they get ripened. And this one I just took it out of the fridge so that it's not too cold when we eat the mango. Looks pretty neat here. And I will put the dishwasher at the end of the day. And this is the plate full of veggie and fruit scraps which we will use in composting. And you might think why this chair is here, because when I do cooking I like to take a seat now and then, because if I want to sit I have to go either to the living room or to the dining place, and it's too far. So if I'm cooking something and if I forgot or get distracted, then it will get burnt. So that's why I keep a chair handy here. And I also keep a cardigan here so that whenever it's too cold for me, I can just put this on and sit here. And I have my phone charger, so I can keep my charging here and I can look at my phone in the breaks I take between cooking. The time is around 7:40, so I'm going to go outside into the backyard, spend some time, come back in and start cooking. So even though the time is around 7:30, it's too sunny, too bright. So earlier I have shown these styrofoam covers that we use in the garden. So this is how we use. So we have lot of birds coming into the backyard. So we are protecting our blackberries with these styrofoam covers. As you can see, we have placed all over the blackberries. So similar way you can protect any kind of fruit with those covers. So green chilies, bell peppers, beans. Let me show you cucumbers. We have Indian cucumbers there. So since I'm making chutney today, I'm going to grab a sprig of curry leaves for chutney. So these are our guavas. So here I found a cool spider web, so I thought I would show you. Look at the pretty weaving. And here I'm harvesting witch gourd as well as some okra. And our okra plants are still small, that's why we get only a couple a day. And these are our Indian variety of tomatoes, similar to heirloom tomatoes. These are difficult to grow, but look at the pretty design on the top. So this is how it looks in the evening at sunset time. It looks so beautiful. I think the camera is not doing any justice, but it looks absolutely beautiful. The sun rays hits the kitchen, you can see. And let me zoom in a little bit so that you can see. Green lush on the fence and bright sun. And before making chutney, I would like to thank all of you guys. Our channel hit 40k subscribers, I think yesterday, and I'm so happy. I'm so thankful to you guys. I really appreciate all of you guys watching my each and every video, liking my Instagram posts and giving me your feedback. It means a lot. And I started this channel 3 years ago, and I didn't think that I would reach this number at that time. But I'm so happy with this immense growth. For some people, it may not be a lot of growth, but for me, it is. Thank you so much. And if you are new to my channel, please do subscribe and join our family. And I hope we reach to a bigger number soon. And let's start cooking. So I'm taking all these tomatoes and some ripened red chili, and these are not spicy at all, so that's why I'm adding to the chutney. And I'm supposed to make this chutney like 2 hours ago, but my camera battery died, and I told you guys that I will show the recipe. That's why now it's like around 8:30, so now I'm making this chutney. So let's do it fast. So first I'm going to wash this very well and chop them into small pieces, and I'm not going to show those steps because everybody knows how to do that. So I have chopped all the tomatoes, and for making the chutney I'm going to use sesame oil. This I got from Costco, and if you don't like sesame oil, you can use any oil of your choice. And I have taken some mustard seeds and the red chilies that I have shown you before, and then I have taken a thick bottomed kadai and then some curry leaves. So let's begin. So once the pan is hot, I'm going to add sesame oil. So I'm going to add 2 to 3 spoons. And after making the chutney, we can see if it needs more oil, then I will add more. But for now, this is enough. Let the oil get hot. So the oil is hot. I'm going to add around 1.5 teaspoon of mustard seeds. So the mustard seeds started popping. I'm going to add curry leaves. And I'm going to add the chilies. So definitely cover with a lid so that it doesn't splatter all over. Fry for 1 or 2 minutes. So after 2 minutes, I'm going to add all the tomatoes. Now let's add some salt. So this is pink Himalayan salt. I'm going to add around 1.5 of this spoon, and we can always check later and add more if needed. So mix well. And put the stove on medium to high heat and let it cook. So if you want, you can keep a lid. I'm not keeping lid now because I want this to cook faster. So now I will let the chutney cook for some time. It will take some time because I took like really huge quantity. But if you are making chutney with only like 5-6 tomatoes, it will be cooked really fast. But this one will take some time. So that's why I'm sitting on this chair. So it is really handy. So if you have a big kitchen and every time if you want to take a seat or take a break in between, definitely have a chair or a stool nearby you. And I'm going to check on the phone, Instagram, YouTube and all that fun stuff. I want to see what's going on and maybe look at my WhatsApp and talk to some friends. So maybe in a couple of minutes I'll show you the progress. So just after 5 minutes it looks like this. So keep stirring in between so that the bottom doesn't get burnt. So after 10 minutes it started to get thick. As you can see, it started at this line. So I kept on high heat, medium to high heat, and then stir in between. And this is a no grind chutney, you don't have to grind it. So after 5 minutes it looks like this. So now you can cook this until all the liquid evaporates. It's up to you, whatever consistency you like. So let me show you. So it's thick like this with only little bit of liquid. So I'm thinking that this is perfect for me because it goes very well with either dosa or rice. And this stays up to 4-5 days in the fridge, even up to a week. And we only added like 2-3 tablespoons of oil. So now I'm going to add red chili powder to taste and check for salt and add more if needed. So to me this consistency is good enough. So before turning off the stove, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of garlic, which I crushed and chopped. This gives a nice taste. And if you don't like garlic, you can add hing. It looks delicious. Like I said, if you want more thicker chutney, you can cook for more time so that all the liquid evaporates. But this is perfect. And you can see small specks of garlic. It gives a nice taste. And now I'm going to turn off the stove. And this is ready. That's it guys, I'm going to end the vlog now. And I hope you try the chutney. It is very simple and very tasty, and if you notice that most of the ingredients are from our garden. The tomatoes, chilies, curry leaves are from the garden. And if you try it, definitely do tag me on Instagram and I'll share your pictures on my feed. And I hope you enjoyed this vlog and give me your feedback in the comments. Give this video a big like and subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram. Thanks for watching and I'll see you again with a new video. Bye!